Welcome to today's video. We will study today present progressive tense. This is a continuation of the last video. If you remember, we studied last time the uses of verbo estar. And the last case that I referred in that video was the uses of estar in progressive tenses, right? And so today we will focus on that particular thing. We need to understand how we build the progressive tenses. We speak a lot in progressive tenses. What is a progressive tense in English? ING forms, right? Now in Spanish, we use the verbo estar and a verb in gerund form, ING, right? So we will go into that details. First of all, progressive tense suggests an action in progress, right? An action that is in progression, right? There is no ending of that action, right? That's the first thing. Second thing that is important to remember or to understand is that even though in English you see progressive in this action, sitting, standing, lying, reclining, we do not see progression in those actions in Spanish. For us, those are simple conditions. Therefore, we refer to those with adjectives. So right now, in English, I can say I'm sitting, but in Spanish, I have to say estoy sentado, right? Why sentado? Because I'm a guy, right? Estoy sentado, estoy parado, estoy acostado. So that's very important to understand that even though you can do it in English, you cannot do it in Spanish. Now, how we create the progressive tense? First of all, we need the verbo estar, the right conjugation of the verbo estar. The verbo estar gives us the tense. Right now we are in present tense, so I will recall the conjugation of verbo estar right now. Yo estoy. Tú estás, él, ella, usted está, nosotros estamos, vosotros estáis, ellos, ellas, and ustedes están. That's very important to understand. Allow me to erase this so I can give the conjugation and see how the verbs work. So, we have, right? So, you need verbo estar. Estoy, estás, está, and so on, estamos, estáis, están, right? I will use other examples in a moment. And then we need a verb in gerund form. And this is the little bit the complicated part in Spanish. You are already familiar with this. In the last video, we studied the conjugation and the uses of verbo estar. And remember, the last use of verbo estar is creating progressive tense. So, what is the gerund form, the ing in English? Well, in Spanish, it's a little bit more complicated because we have three forms. And let me go to those three forms. If the verbo ending in ar, like the case of verbo hablar, right? This is an ar verb, that's the first family in Spanish. The ending, the ing, will be translated into ando. And I will do it in a moment. I will do this conjugation in a moment for you. If the verbo ending in er or ir, let's say the examples of comer or the verbo vivir, see the endings, er or ir, the ing form will be yendo, right? So we will substitute the endings, the families, for these endings. And if the verbo is the verbo ir as to go, or is another verb ending in double vowel verbs like the verbo leer, see what I mean here, double vowels, or the verbo oír, double vowels, right? Or caer, or traer, or poseer, this has to be substituted, the ending has to be substituted by yendo, right? That's the way that we substitute that. Now, by the way, yendo is the ing form of the verbo ir, as to go, all right? So let me go back, let me erase this part and go back and do some examples for you. In the form of erasing, I can use a progressive tense. Estoy borrando, see? That's a progressive action. It's an action in progress. I'm doing something that takes a little bit of time, right? Estoy borrando. Now I will start with another action in progress. Estoy escribiendo, right? So verbo estar, right? Estoy. Let's say that I will use hablar, right? Remember, hablar is an adverb. I have to substitute the family, the ar, for ando. Remember that, right? So let me erase the family. It's like a normal conjugation in Spanish. Now we have the stem, right? What I do with that stem, I add, and allow me to use a different color so you can see that. Ando, right? Estoy hablando. This is the ing form, right? This is the form that expresses the action in progress. Now, estoy hablando what? Estoy hablando español. Right? What about if I want to use another verb? Estoy borrando. Right? The verb borrar is also an adverb. Right? Borrar. See? Adverb. I erase that and I put the ing form in Spanish, ando. Estoy borrando. Now I can use any other subject. Estás, right? Comer is the infinitive form, right? I cannot do that. What I do, I have to erase that infinitive form, that family, and replace it. Remember, adverbs follow yendo, right? And I have to take this part and attach it here. So I have to do comiendo una ensalada. Right? Estás comiendo una ensalada. You are eating a salad, right? Comiendo is translated as eating. Let me use another verb, verbo vivir. Vivir is the infinitive, right? We don't need the infinitive. We erase the family. Viv is the stem, and I will attach the endings, the ing ending that is the same as adverbs like comer. Or ir verbs follow the same and has the same ending. Yendo. Estás viviendo en Estados Unidos, right? Viviendo. This is the gerund form, right? Now, these two verbs here, estás viviendo, form a present progressive tense, a presente progresivo en español, right? Now, let me move to the last group, and I will use a different form of estar. I will use nosotros. Estamos. Nosotros estamos. Remember, you don't need nosotros. Remember the verbs ir, as to go, leer, oír, caer, right? Double vowel verbs. See those two vowels here, those two vowels here, those two vowels here. All these follow yendo, right? That is the form of verbo ir, right? So I will use leer. So I put infinitive here. I do not need the infinitive. I have to erase the family, right? Le is the stem, and I have to attach the endings. Estamos leyendo un libro. Estamos leyendo un libro. Allow me to use a different verb and a different subject. Ellas están. I will use the verbo oír. That's the infinitive form. I erase the infinitive, right? And O is my stem. And remember, I have to attach yendo. And now I have the sentence, ellas están oyendo. This is the progressive, this is the ing form, right? The combination of the two verbs, the verbo estar plus the ing form, give us the progressive tense. Ellas están oyendo la radio, right? They are listening or they are hearing the radio, right? This is the way that we form the progressive tense. This is the way that we construct progressive forms in Spanish. Remember, Do not use sitting, standing, lying, or reclining, because we do not see those four forms in Spanish as progressive. We saw those as conditions, therefore we need to use adjectives. I hope that this is helpful for you and you can practice. Now let me finish this giving you a general question that you can use to create your own sentence. And these questions, by the way, this question will introduce the next topic. The next video will be focused in questions, how to ask questions in Spanish. So I will ask this general question for you. ¿Qué está? I will treat you as formal. ¿Qué está haciendo? Right? What are you doing? Right? Haciendo. The infinitive of the verb here is hacer. It's an er verb, right? Er verbs, remember, follow the yendo form, right? So this is the stem, and see what happened. ¿Qué está usted, right, haciendo? And if you try to answer that, the only way to answer that most likely is using progressive tense. Remember my advice, practice, practice, and practice. That's the only way to progress in learning a foreign language, and so long for now.